used, is this one is used. So we need to put this into the sharp part. I'm gonna put this to you, and then you can put it out.
Technically, the thing is that when you would start
and into the sharp box,
you would actually have an IV kit.
Right.
Okay. So in the IV kit,
right here, and
you would find your tegaderm.
Right.
Okay. You would probably have a couple of
what we need to do first, we need
probably
to have
fluids ready. Something
to hang on.
Okay. And then you would probably have your fluids. I just call it the day lube, I call it Teflon. The oldest one I'm putting on an IV is just now look lighter on it. And we have our two patients from the ER. They have an IV in and then they just put a cap on it. Well, that's not helpful. You know, we always have things ready to hook up
so that we don't have an exposure thing. The needle.
Other thing with loops,
let me get this cap. So gather your equipment and start your
This is the hanger. I could open it, right?
Yes, you may.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That before you put your spike in your bag, you want to clamp your clamp. Otherwise, you're going to have fluid on the floor.
Oh, what?
You'll do it once. Yes, you'll do it once. I guarantee it.
So I'm going to have you triangulate and go ahead and put this on. So our spike, this is a needleless system.
So this is where you would pull that off.
And then you want to put those on the ends. This is the part that's going to go on your
hand.
So technically,
okay, now hold that in your one hand. Now where's your spike?
It should be like a little end cap. So
my spike is right here.
Right, so now uncap your spikes.
That's going to control your needles. The only thing you're making sure is that you double up.
Okay.
That's what you're going to use.
Okay, so this is the chamber, but it's okay to
leave it out like that, because if you were then going to use it, you have to get an alcohol swab. So that's all right.
Scrub the hub for like 15 seconds or something.
That's what that is. Yep.
Scrub the hub.
You're saying phrases I'm remembering. Okay. So now slowly open your clamp and watch your fluid flow down your tubing.
So if I wasn't using it, the way that I just did this, I was like, I pulled it and pulled it out and let this part in.
You wouldn't let it stay in because basically that's going to be the part that's just going to be connected to the patient.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Nice.
Okay.
Now you've got your tubing.
So that's good.
It's
ready,
ready
to go.
Okay. Let's get a hand flush so you can hang it. This guy is going to hang high.
If you were going to start an IV and you didn't have to draw one, you would want to flush that. That's called priming it. You would want to prime your little tubing first. If you were going to start the IV and it was good enough, and you felt that you could get blood from it, you wouldn't prime it, because then you would get that saline in the blood. Exactly.
Yes.
So we're just going to start IV.
So we're ready to start an IV, but we need an IV start kit. For safety.
So what that has in it is it has your tourniquet in it, it has your alcohol prep. It has an occlusive dressing.
Now because you have two pigtails.
Mm-hmm. Everything you have is all wrapped in one.
So all of it is all. Do you always find it together, or
you don't find it together? Depending on the facility that you're working in, you may find it together and you may not.
So, and you have to flush it enough to get
is
the
the, yeah, well, to the end there.
We've got our tourniquet, our alcohol, we've got a gauze. We don't have an occlusive dressing and we don't have tape. Okay.
It kind of twists, you push and twist.
Oh.
Yeah, push, put, you got it, you got to hold on to your
really good
push and twist.
Needle,
so. There you go.
We just
might
have to
find. Yep.
Okay.
So go ahead and flush that one.
Can you just this?
Yeah, go
ahead. As long as you're aware.
Okay, good. And then you can take it, and then what you would do here is you see the little
and then
white clamps on. Clamp the one that you just flushed. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and clamp that one. I know, it's a lot to do, isn't it? Just to get ready to start an IV.
Okay. So what you can do is do a little bit of a test.
That's exactly it. Yep, that's exactly it. Okay.
And then we'll go to this one.
Yep, go to that one. And then flush that one.
So it's fine, right?
It's just going to be a process of learning.
And I'm going to show you something that I like to do with the tape.
Okay, you go ahead and flush that one.
An IV. I like to rip it this way. And then I have, once the IV is in, then I will take this
and
chevron.
And take that off.
Oh, okay.
You can probably put the cap back on.
And then I put my occlusive dressing on. It's an old time thing. What could I say?
All right, perfect.
So whichever way is going to anchor that.
Yes, get your tourniquet.
In the arm that is so not going to come loose.
I'm going to make sure that tourniquet
is the way you want to do it.
Try that one. Okay. Okay. Blood.
Hopefully that. I like this one.
Yes, we do.
That's a good one.
I have to start tourniquet first.
Yep.
This is dangerous.
About 4 inches from the site where you want to insert your needle is where you want to have your tourniquet. Yes.
Or you
can
have it, let's see,
you know,
I'm not pushing anymore.
You have
tape
somewhere?
That's the part I think.
That's
the well, you know. Murphy's Law, that might be missing.
What? I mean, hey.
So here's something with your tail.
Yes.
Do so it upwards?
If we put our tails up, then they're out of our way.
There we go.
It's like any tape in the world.
Another thing you'd want to do is get some strips ready. And you can probably just like take them to the like to the edge of the table so that they're hanging out.
There we go. Now our tails are up. Mm-hmm. They're out of our way.
Yep. All right.
I know if they don't stick to
okay.
So I would have to clean it.
All right.
All right, now
and it air dry.
We just talked
right?
about
get this ready.
Mm-hmm.
Turn it.
Bees are not safety needles.
Okay.
Bees aren't. But, I mean, we can certainly do the same thing.
It out.
So I just wanted to show
level
you
up.
Where you open it. It's kind of like a twist.
Bellow up.
That's how correct. You the seal.
Where are you putting off. Your right hand?
My right hand is going to be.
These are older needles.
Pulling it down.
Yes, anchor your vein.
You're going to see your flashback. Okay. Like this entire thing in here is the needle. And this you never want to do, but just so that you realize, that will get pushed off because this is your hemlock.
A little pressure.
But this entire needle pressure. That's why it's so much better to have a
okay.
Okay.
What you're very shallow
and you never want your insertion.
And so you never want to bring it all back.
That's
bring it all back. Go a little bit.
When you get to your vein and you push it in there, then you push your angle forward and press this back.
Okay, I got it.
And now advance your
cannula forward.
Yep, hold pressure here. We've got our tubing ready.
And I'll walk you through it.
Okay.
Alrighty. Okay, so, get your site ready.
We're going to connect. Never let go of your needle until you have an anchor.
Colors come through. You don't have.
Oh yeah,
because
tape.
If you, yes, you got your tape.
I'm gonna move your needle out of your way.
I should have opened this first. Try to take care of everything first.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep.
So we want our occlusive dressing on here. You clean up your site very nicely.
Do you leave a piece of cloth? Oh no, the dressing is gonna go.
Right, the dressing is gonna go over that. When I'm dry,
you see how this breaks apart?
First thing, there is this one side.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. You drive with these fingers, with your thumb and your middle finger, and then you push off.
Okay, so this
is good. Okay. So let's see how we do it.
This is for medication.
No, we're not. I'm sorry. Don't worry, we've got plenty of needles in this, but I don't mind you practice it.
Yes.
Now. Right. Good, smooth it out.
Okay, now let's see, did you get a flash?
Yes,
you did. Now go ahead and push the catheter forward with your index finger.
Like this.
You fight.
And take this out.
Your other side.
And so then, what's going to happen here is this thing's going to clean all over you.
No, you're like, you're all
right. And now is where your tape comes in.
Which is why the newer catheter is
better. Can I take right here?
Because
anchor it.
When this, when you push this forward,
and this becomes, you don't want to go in anywhere. It's in there, we want to
have that plastic piece on it. You can't do that with this time. So then what you would need to do is this finger, you would have to push down.
And the tape may not fit this very well on this.
Grab this.
Remember in the room?
And screw it on.
What do we want to do when I turn it
down? Go ahead and grab it off.
Okay.
Okay. This guy, it's all a matter of
good
practice. Like seriously, it's all practice.
You would adjust your flow rate to what you want it is. And this drip chamber is what?
What you could do until you get this open is going to be
okay.
Depending
on what your rate is, you're going to have to figure out how many.
This one okay. Don't put it over the site, but not your finger and put it like over the
don't mat. You count it?
Yes.
And what do you have to have next to that?
Yes. So then, it doesn't do this in a record. It really doesn't.
Okay.